my health visitor comes and sees me whenever I ask her. I almost feel like I have like a quality relationship with her. She knows both of my kids, she knows what's going on with them.
I think for me it's just nice to know that there is support there. Whether I use it or not, I don't know.
They're a bit realistic, they don't expect to be this perfect mum first time.
I've not sort of been left to sort of have to find out things on my own. Everything that I've sort of asked, I've got a response for.
I always really look forward to coming round.
Health visitors support families by checking the health and welfare of children and mothers, from newborn right up to when your child starts school. This film highlights some of the key stages and support services within the service to help you and your family get the most out of what is on offer. Primary visits usually take place when your child is between 10 and 14 days old. A health visitor will discuss what level of support is required and what services are on offer, as well as giving practical support in those important first few weeks and months.
Hello.
Good morning.
Hi there.
I'm Yvonne.
Hi, you're Yvonne.
Amanda.
Come in.
I've
yes,
got my badge to prove it.
Come in.
Thank you very much. Here with all my luggage.
Thank you.
So you've got all of your things here. That's fantastic.
Yeah.
I come bearing gifts.
Okay, great.
And with lots of paperwork to do, I'm afraid. So here I have the Birth to Five book, which is a very precious thing, given out to first-time parents only. Uh-huh. So hang on to it. Covers just about everything you can think of to do with babies from birth to five, believe
okay.
it or not. Also loads of websites at the back
yeah.
for information.
Okay.
Really good resource. And it gives you a lot of confidence too, because if you think, oh, what should I do about, I think I might try that.
Yeah.
If you check in here,
okay.
rather than having to phone a friend,
yeah.
it just makes you more confident,
okay.
really, I think, in the whole process.
She talks a little bit about how we've been getting on with the midwife and what's gone on. She talks a little bit about breastfeeding and how we're going with the breastfeeding. She'll also tell us about the other members of the health visiting team that we may come in contact with, and also the different clinics where we can go and get the baby weighed and get support as well, either at the GP surgery or at the clinic. So how often will we see the health visitor? Will we see the health visitor now until she goes to school? Or
yeah.
Yeah.
But a gradually lengthening intervals.
Yeah.
So, you know, you don't see, it's not as intensive as the midwifery service.
There was a lot of information that was given at that visit, but also it gives the opportunity to, you know, to ask questions or things that we had concerns about.
Some mothers, if required, will receive an additional home visit at around 4 weeks. It is a chance to discuss problems and concerns, check that the baby is developing well, and to ensure that the mother is healthy and supported.
The nursery nurse came along and weighed the baby to check her weight, which was nice, sort of quite reassuring and encouraging to see that she's put on weight. And also, again, more information about support groups that we can go to meet other mums, but also groups that are going to help with Bella's sort of development and sort of learning as she goes along.
But we'll give you this little booklet as well. This has got various groups in,
yeah,
in the area. You might like to go and try when you feel ready. The swimming at Linden Road, when if you're ready to go
yeah.
swimming, they do little baby lessons.
Do they?
Lovely.
Did you hear
yeah.
that?
Absolutely lovely.
Again, they talked about breastfeeding and offered support for breastfeeding, different ways that we can get support, and also winding, different positions that we might want to feed
sometimes
in.
Sometimes that helps. Feel a bit colicky. And are you feeling okay yourself, Amanda?
Yeah, I mean, I'm tired, but
yeah.
I think that's probably, you know, to be expected.
Oh,
but
gosh,
other than
yeah.
that, I
yeah.
feel...
So are you happy to attend clinic after this visit, or would you like us to...
No, I can walk up. No, I can walk up. Either way, really, it's equidistance, isn't it, between...
Yeah,
that's fine.
Okay, if ever you feel that you can't
manage
to come out,
okay.
if you've been too tired or you're not feeling well, then we can come to see you at home.
Okay.
At around 8 weeks, the baby is given a medical checkup by their GP, along with the baby's first vaccination. Some GPs will also assess the mother's health.
They will do a physical check of her, a physical check of you, not too invasive these days, thank goodness. And she will then have her immunisations.
Okay.
The main purpose of doing the check at this age is just to look at all the anatomical aspects of the baby and make sure that there's no problems with the lungs, the heart and eyes and ears and things like that. And also to check on the developmental parameters, make sure that she's looking well, that she moves all her limbs very well, that kind of thing. There's certain things that they're able to do at this age, like when I pull her up to sit, she can lift the head up and hold it quite steady for a few seconds, and she can actually do that a lot better than expected at this age. And that's basically it. And checking the hips as well and a few other things. And it's also an opportunity for mum to ask if there's any problems with baby, to ask for some advice, that kind of thing.
Okay, that's good. You didn't mind that.
Yeah. That's normally the worst bit.
I can do that, that's fine.
Okay, thanks.
All children are offered a programme of routine immunisations designed to protect them from potentially dangerous diseases. You will be sent appointments for 2, 3, 4, 12 and 13 months, with a further injection at 3 years and 4 months, before your child starts school.
We want to be looking at immunisation rates of well above 80% to make sure that we get that herd immunity, which means that we do not see the return of very dangerous childhood illnesses to our community. And I think people have forgotten really how serious measles is, for example, and we are seeing pockets of measles back in parts of our community, but in fact what we're relying on is that the majority of the community do take up the immunisation programme.
The programme is at 2 months, 3 months and 4 months is their primary immunisations. Then they have a booster dose, their hep men C at 12 months old, their MMR and pneumonia at 13 months old. Then at 3 years and 4 months, they have their preschool booster and a second MMR.
So she's having her diphtheria, tetanus, pertussis, polio and HIV in one injection and a meningitis C in the next one.
Okay.
Okay? And just before we start, the next ones are due in 4 weeks and she'll have three.
Three next time.
Yeah, two in one leg and one in the other.
Is it one in one leg and one in the other today?
It is, yes.
The nurses themselves who give the immunisations are always absolutely fab, so they are real child friendly, so, you know, it's not major. But, however, some parents have needle phobia and it can be a bit scary for them, and that's where we support them.
Child health clinics are run by health visitors, doctors and nursery nurses and offer regular health and developmental reviews. You can talk about any problems to do with your child, including questions around breastfeeding, weaning, sleep patterns and where to get additional support.
We want to see a happy, healthy child who's following the normal developmental milestones and is accessing a full programme of immunisations, and whose mum and family unit are well and happy and well supported and accessing everything that's available within the community. For example, able to attend things that are on offer at the local children's centre.
I'm sure he's put on some weight.
Okay, so shall we go and strip him off?
Yeah.
Weight, height and head circumference are measured at regular intervals on a centile chart. The expectation being that when the child settles onto a centile, he or she stays within a short distance of that centile line.
We've seen how tall you are.
Girl.
She's not right at the top, is that?
Not at the top, hang on, let's have a little...
Parents can drop in whenever there is a session. Clinics are based in both health venues and community settings and are tailored to work around the needs of families, whatever their circumstances. Penny runs a clinic in a women's hostel.
I provide the health visiting service into the hostel, and as part of that, I come into the hostel once a week to run a well baby clinic. So the mums can come down to the clinic as often as they want, but I will also negotiate with them when I feel I need to see them. I hope that we try and look at the mother and the child holistically, and so we'll also discuss the maternal health and any issues they may have.
Your health visitor will discuss with you the most convenient and appropriate clinics for your needs, or arrange further home visits.